constellation. And this term, I have to briefly refer to the origin of the term, or at least to the artist Hildesheim, and that was Eindhoven. So it's a collaboration, of course, between our university and the art history department and the Van Abbe Museum. And the term constellation is asking for a different practice of how to deal with history, of how to narrate history. And it, the origin of this term goes back into the 19th century, but is rediscovered and rethought and developed, especially by Walter Benjamin. And the question is very simple. When we, as an institution, like historians, deal with history, we try to create a certain artificial distance to what is the past and what is the present. And within this creation of a distance, we try to put events into a timeline, to line them up, and to make connections that are cause-effect connections. So once something happened like this, then as an effect of that, something else happened and so on. And this is a very convenient way, of course, to keep a certain distance. And in the 19th century, when the science of writing history has been actually invented, yeah, there was immediately criticism raised, for example, by Jakob Burckhardt, who was saying, but wait a minute, isn't history a very, very complex thing that is not just based on recorded events that someone, like an archivar, like an archive, writes down and then we have it and from here we reconstruct something? What about those living things that are at the same time working together, not obviously working together? For example, this astonishing book about art and culture of the Renaissance is exactly trying to do this. Instead of talking about art and culture, I mean, he is talking about art and culture, he lists political practice, which is astonishingly gruesome. He talks about how they, how families like the Medici and many, many others were bringing power relations together, how they were in very cruel and very gruesome ways establishing power. And every now and then, in between, he mentions, well, and a painting by Raphael showing Maria holding the dead body of Christ is actually a memory of a mother whose son died in one of these street fights that he witnessed when he was a child. So there is a connection between things that occur and things that are transformed into culture. Benjamin says, to think history in a different way, we always have to think it from our presence. And our presence is naturally something else than the past was. But, he says, if we want to get a relation to the past, then this present can only articulate this relation when it understands itself as addressed, as meant by this past. So that every presence has to establish a relation towards what we call past, and this is then not a past anymore, but something that has an effect that occurs like different layers of temporality within our presence. So this idea that we are surrounded by different pasts and that these pasts are addressing a presence is at the same time the problem of how to do a narrative that can't be a linear narrative anymore. And so Benjamin was looking at the work of the surrealists who invented a different way to address contemporality and something that is related to a past, and that was the collage, the montage, so putting things together like Rakow called it later a revue-like philosophy that lights up little things, little events, yeah, that come together in one presence and suddenly reveal insight into connections, into power relations of the past. past that would not occur if you try to make sense in a linear operation. Benjamin thought of something like in his book Einbahnstraße is an example for that, bringing brief and very pronounced, very concrete events, observations of everyday life. And within these, he is able to prepare, to bring out, to bring out this relation to what the thinking of history, of what it means for our presence, that the presence is relying to it, that the presence is part of this. So, in one word, the constellation that we are thinking about and that has to deal with a different notion of history, the constellation makes possible views of that, what Benjamin called the invisible, that is not written, that you don't find in an archive, but you find it when you walk to the street, to a town. Of course, we have Paris in his mind, the different layers of time always occur right in your face. Yeah? Things that are contemporary, things that are from far away, and he has this image of the passage. The passage is something, as an artificial construction that enables the flaneur or the one who's walking through it, enables him to get different sorts of insights into parallel universes, you would say, into parallel things that happen that you would not connect when you want to make sense in a linear thing. So how to do this, or other examples we are looking for in bringing these different layers of time to the mind of a present observer that understands that his presence is always a multiple layered result of many, many past, many, many events that go very, very far away. This the archive itself, or exhibiting an archive or making an archive visible, is not working unless you connect this with this I would say unless you can connect it with a different practice, which is the artistic practice that tries to bring up constellation. The constellations are could be materialized things like artworks, things or photography. We have it maybe here. A photography that the artist Jeremy Della found in a British newspaper photography from, I think, 1973, that shows Adrian Street. The man comes from a coal mining background. Here you see him on the right side with his father, and he developed into something completely different, which is this show wrestler thing. And Jeremy Della understands immediately this, with this little thing from the past, this photography, you can write the whole history of the social changes within England, and you have it in a nutshell. And from here, you can start working with constellations. There is another photo we have here. It's just part of an exhibition we made, and he sometimes works with many, many different artists who actually produce then images from one of his actual dresses. It's Wester. It's in here. Can I have the rest of the photography again? What this term constellation is about is that the perception of the users of constellation is asked and is enhanced in a way that no written history can do. Because these constellations are actually already, even this document is forming constellations. You can see certain similarities even between the father and this son that grew into something completely different. Transgender things are mentioned here and are absolutely vital to understand what happens within Western society. So, to make it brief, I think we're over the time again. The term constellation that occurs in Adorno, occurs in thinking about the use of film and other media, the term constellation is only used to help understanding that these multiple connections that we ought to draw if you want to see or if you want to understand or comprehend what we call history as a non-linear, from multiple sources coming question, yeah, that is asked every presence, that this constellation topic is something that we cannot solve on a theoretical basis, but we believe with the practices that maybe artists produce instead of historians, we have a tool at hand to give insight into what is meant by making history visible or making history physical, yeah? Creating awareness of these long-term conditions we are still a part of. Thank you.
What you were looking at as a slideshow that was running on examples from the Valhalla Museum programming for the last 6 years, where we experience that we've been working more and more with the collection and with the archive, experimenting with different forms of exhibiting constellations, you could say. And what you saw were very different types of exhibition and archive presentations that all in one way or another tried another formula out on how to make visible and accessible these different types of constellations.